The Adventures of Man Sponge and Boy Patrick and What Were You Shrinking? Chapter 5, Whale of a Tale. A beam of strange light came out of the belt. It hit a barrel of pickles. The barrel shrank pickles and all until it was as tiny as a thimble. SpongeBob balanced the barrel of pickles on the end of his finger.
Wow! He marveled. The small ray!
He remembered one time when Mermaid Man had used the small ray. Man Sponge and Boy Patrick were finishing up another day of keeping Bikini Bottom safe when Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy drove up in the invisible boatmobile.
Man Sponge, come quickly! There's a new villain in town and we need your help!
Mermaid Man said. Man Sponge and Boy Patrick hopped in the back seat. They roared off, heading towards City Hall. When they got there, they ran into the mayor's office. The mayor had been tied up. Sitting in his chair was the biggest fish that Man Sponge had ever seen. Mermaid Man pointed an accusing finger at the huge fish.
Get out of the mayor's chair immediately, he ordered.
The gigantic fish chuckled a low, menacing laugh. Then he stood up. His head grazed the ceiling.
You listen to me, pal. I'm Whale Shark, and I'm the biggest fish in the sea. That means what I say goes. Not if I have anything to say about it,
Mermaid Man said bravely. Whale Shark took one step and loomed over Mermaid Man.
Oh yeah?
He asked.
And what exactly do you have to say about it, little man?
Mermaid Man gulped.
Well, I haven't exactly had time to put my thoughts in order. I'm really better with a prepared speech.
Things looked bad for Mermaid Man and Barnacle Boy. Just as Whale Shark was about to attack them, Man Sponge shouted,
Mermaid Man, your belt, the small ray!
Oh yeah,
Mermaid Man cried. He punched a button on his belt.
Zap!
The strange beam hit Whale Shark, making him glow for a second. Then he shrank down to the size of a sea nut.
Hey!
He squeaked.
What'd you do to me?
Yay!
Boy Patrick cheered, picking up Whale Shark with no problem. Mermaid Man turned to Man Sponge.
Thanks, Man Sponge. We couldn't have done it without you.
Man Sponge blushed modestly.
Aw, it was nothing really.
At least that was the way SpongeBob remembered it. He couldn't resist playing with the small ray, and soon he had created a tiny Krusty Krab kitchen with things that he shrunk. Squidward heard all the zapping and laughing and came into the kitchen to investigate.
SpongeBob, what's going on in here?
He asked. Squidward stared at all the things SpongeBob had shrunk. His hat? His spatula? Even a miniature Krabby Patty for a bug to eat at a little table.
Why is everything so tiny? Squidward asked suspiciously.
I don't know,
SpongeBob replied sheepishly, trying to hide the belt behind his back.
What have you got there? Squidward asked.
Nothing.
No, really, let's see it.
Then he gasped.
Is that Mermaid Man's belt?
Yes!
SpongeBob's teeth chattered with nerves.
Wow, I find it hard to believe he'd lend it to you,
Squidward remarked.
Me either,
SpongeBob let out. Squidward gasped with disbelief when the truth finally sank in.
He didn't lend it to you, did he?
Stay tuned for Chapter 6, coming up soon.